Seems not a good moment to talk.
What can I do you for? Well now, maybe I could make his acquaintance. Titan screw or two might let me keep a little calmer. Maybe even manage a pat or bump without burning someone to death. It's been a long time.
Speak.
Oakfather's blessings to you. I studied one up close. Closer than most would care to be to those things. A drow attacked me and I defended myself. Afterwards, I was able to examine the tadpole that emerged. Hideous, but fascinating. Like nothing else in nature, I'm glad to say.
Cozy setup you have here. I'll just make myself comfortable. Thank you so much.
Well met.
He brings to mind a story. The Devil with the Silver Tongue. An old fairy tale my father read to me. The kind with a hero, a villain, and a moral. A farmer made a deal with the devil, so the story goes. In exchange for the farmer's dearest fruit, the devil granted him a bottomless coin purse. The farmer's dearest fruit, naturally, was no apple nor peach, but his beloved daughter. We can learn a lot from fairy tales, don't you think? Refuse him, no matter how tempting the offer, no matter how delicious the feast he lays out for you. The cost will be too great. That's because you still have hope. But when he becomes your last hope, remember this. He'll require of you only what you're least ready to part with, and then require more still. You might think you'd give up anything for a cure, but the devil won't take just anything. He'll take everything. A possibility that's kept me awake countless nights. But I don't have a clue where to start, other than play her games and play by the rules. That's the only language devils listen to. She could kill me for one, and that's not the worst of it.
My contract is very clear. I can bring Mazora no harm. She'll have to let me out of my pact willingly.
The only way out is if I can out-bargain her. We're standing here with nothing but the clothes on our backs and the worms in our heads.
We can, I'm sure of it.
How glad I am that you see me as more than my patron's pet.
These boots have seen everything.
Go ahead. I'm listening.
Ah, yes. Karsus. Karsus was perhaps the most powerful wizard that ever lived. The child who would be a god, the elves called him. And he tried. With a spell of his own devising, he endeavored to usurp in one fell swoop the power of the goddess of magic. Mistril, she was called then. Imagine what it must have felt like to be a god, to know yourself, to be untouchable, to be mistaken. As Karsus aimed his spell at her, she began to unravel, and with her, the entire weave. Too late did he realize what he had unleashed. It would have been the end of everything had not Mistril sacrificed herself. The goddess of magic is all magic. By dying, the entire weave was lost, and the spell that challenged a god failed. It was the end of Mistril, the end of Karsus, and the end of an entire civilization. As the child who would be a god was turned to stone, his empire came crashing down around him. The floating cities of Netheril were no more. An event that came to be known as Karsus's folly. For a spell, Mistril was reborn as Mistra. Upon her return, the weave returned with her. Now, so many centuries later, I try to follow in the footsteps of Karsus. Not to destroy Mistra, but to prove my love for her. Tried to control only a fraction of the magic that was unleashed that fateful day. I merely sought to return one tiny diamond to an imperfect crown. Gale's folly, one might call it. History. Repetition. It's the way things go.
All's well, I hope. No. I just wanted to see how you felt after the night we spent together. When we talked and kissed. I hope so too. Though I'm not sure what kind of courtship will be afforded. Given all that we're facing. But if you want to see where this goes, I do as well. You already know my biggest secrets. What more can you ask? She took me in when no one else would. Without her, I wouldn't be alive. She's my mother. She nurtures me, cares for me, loves me. Don't believe the lies the Saloonites tell. What, besides my life's calling and the greatest problem I've ever faced? Well, I like night orchids and can't swim. Is that the sort of thing you meant? It's a deal. No, I can't. Quite literally, I mean. With my memory suppressed, I can't betray Shah's secrets. And I can't remember much of myself, either. If I manage to return to Baldur's Gate and fulfill Shah's mission, then my memories will be restored. Of course, it is an act of faith, not to be undertaken lightly. Shah will reward me when I succeed.
Carry a Githyanki relic. I will have an explanation. Or your head.
Walk away. Now. I won't warn you again.
That artifact is an heirloom of my people. Likely she spilled Githyanki blood in order to steal it. This cannot stand.
Heirloom? Plunder from some conquered realm, more like. This artifact is the only thing keeping us from becoming slaves to our parasites. Be glad I have it. Nozel thinks I have something important to her people. She's deluded, clear.
Lies. She carries an heirloom of my people. I must know why. Incorrect. Judicious bloodletting settles feuds and roots out the weak, the deceitful.
Do you hear this, Tripe? Our lives are at stake, and she wants us to turn on each other.
No others. Just you and me. Blood must be purged. A jewel, come first light.
You mean I'd get to prove you wrong and thrash you? I love it. Get some rest, Lozel. You'll need it. You had every chance to look the other way, but here we are. You chose this.
Spare me the justifications, coward!
If anyone asks, I'll say you were transforming. Don't expect to be mourned. She's a liability. It's the artifact we need, not her.
Let me up, and I'll show you.
Can I do that, Lozel? Can I turn my back on you?
Never. Thieves aren't afforded such luxury.
Loosen the grip on your pride for one blasted moment, won't you? We needn't be enemies. Plenty of those to go around already.
What would you have? That we be friends?
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. But imagine what we might achieve if we channeled some of that hostility back at our real foes, instead of each other. They wouldn't stand a chance.
Very glad Shadowheart and Lazel settled things without letting any blood. I would have enjoyed the spectacle, but not losing either one of those lunatics.
I really thought Shadowheart and Lazel might fight to the death over that artifact. A pity. It would have made for a fine night's entertainment.
Speak. It is over where I am concerned. It is through conflict that we strengthen our bonds. Yet I do not recommend Shadowheart seek it again. The next resolution may not end in her favor.
You wish to speak?
I hope that's the end of this silly quarrel. They'll have no energy for battling our enemies if Lazel and Shadowheart are too busy squabbling among themselves.
I'll say one thing for our troop. We're not short on drama. I'm glad Shadowheart and Lazel settled their differences peacefully. Eventually.
I think there'll be any more trouble between Lazel and I, if you were wondering. We can all sleep easier now. Well, apart from all the rest. You have an interesting definition of friendly, but yes.
Your skills are improving.
My skills were just fine to begin with. You can save the compliments.
I don't pay compliments. I make observations.
There's something I want to talk to you about. Something important. I could have died in that pod, back on the Nautiloid. You could have died, spending precious moments trying to free me, but you did it anyway. I owe you my life. Twice over, in fact. You supported me against Lazel. I may not have survived that night without you. I'm trying to say that you've earned my trust in a way very few ever have. I want that to mean something. I want you to know more about me. At least from what I can remember. As long as I've prayed to Lady Shah, I've wished to serve her as a Dark Justiciar. There is scarcely a greater way to fully dedicate yourself to Lady Shah, save perhaps if you become the head of her church. To become a Dark Justiciar is to become the Night Singer's sword arm. Her implement with which she will cast down the unbelievers and win the final battle to restore her perfect, endless darkness. It's all I ever wanted. I prayed it was my calling. But Mother forbid me from seeking to prove myself worthy of the rank. She said I was not ready. Not my mother, I should add. The Mother Superior. Head of Lady Shah's enclave in Baldur's Gate. Sometimes I wonder if she would ever deem me ready. I owe her everything, and I only wish to serve, yet she can prove inscrutable. I don't know. Perhaps if I succeed in my mission and reach Baldur's Gate, hope has little place amongst Lady Shah's children. It's an illusion, a distraction. But for this, I hope my time will yet come. Dark Justiciars are hated by many, judged to be ruthless fanatics. Even the few who would accept a follower of Lady Shah would likely balk at a Justiciar in their midst. But there's a simpler answer to your question. I simply forgot about the desire I had until I saw some things that reminded me. Now, I can't get it out of my mind.
At the ready.
Eager for battle. Whatever comes, I'm ready. Thank you.
have a lot on my mind. And, well, eat it. Moving in.
Murderous glare of a red cap, a fey creature known for its bloodlust, greets you. That noise. Is the creature pretending to be a sheep?
You seize me? Nosy, scum-sucking, lice-ridden little ball bag! Get out! Or I bite's tongue, eat's tongue, oh, delicious tongue. Oh, precious baby, loves to bleed you, yes. Turn your corpse into sponge, lots of holes, yes. Leave now, or I'll fill you with holes and more.
Something good here, I hope.
Thank you.
Ellie's entire body shakes. It ribbits erratically as if in pain. It shies away, croaking a warning, eyes wide in terror.
Mistra.
I will ascend. It does it.
What to do? If not over, then through. open up. Never wanted the easy path. A break.
go. Does it?
Let's try.
little
you
help,
will
please.
Not take me.
Spite does wonders.
Ah, excellent choice.
Very well.
If I don't get my beauty sleep soon, I may just get a tad malcontent.
I'm not going to last much longer.
Quite ready for you.
No one's stopped me yet.
Tending.
best be on my way.
There's something I've been wanting to share with you. If now's a good time. It's difficult to put into words. I think it might be easier to just show you. Use the tadpole. The connection. Come into my mind. I'm sure. I trust you. How I came to be who I am. How I found my way to Lady Shah's embrace. I don't remember how it started. Only how it ended. I was fleeing. My name. I can't remember what I said. I can't remember anything before those words. All I know is she saved my life and gave me a new home with Lady Shah. That's all I remember. Lady Shah. But yes, her and those who saved me and taught me her ways. The Mother Superior. She made me who I am. At least as best as I can remember. She taught me, trained me, punished me when I failed her, which was often. Perhaps I was. She sent me on this mission, after all.
else in here?
That might be worth a look.
What's that?
Something's on my mind.
Ah, a fellow wanderer. Forgive the aroma.
You catch a waft of something foul, metallic, and sickly sweet.
Powdered iron vine. Most monsters will think twice before making a meal of me. An old hunter's trick. If you can't mask your scent, spoil it. Today? The same as you. A humble supplicant come to bargain with the lady of this house. That is why you came to her lair, I take it. To bargain. A more innocent name than some I could call her. But it is what she is that ought to concern you. Her kind have hidden among us since the first darkness. And their knowledge is matched only by their spite. Know how to ask, and they'll share that knowledge. If you're fool enough to pay their price. Whatever's easiest to lose, and the hardest to do without. But the thing I hunt has gone to ground. If she can tell me how to draw him out, I'll pay whatever she asks. Truth is like a blade, my friend. We can arm ourselves with it, or just as easily find it pressed against our throat. I would not put you in danger. Kind offer, but to accept it would be no kindness at all, I assure you. Besides, I must survive what waits in that house. One terror at a time, hmm? Go ahead. The lady of the house awaits.
Fetid smell assaults your nostrils. Dead flesh lies below. A great deal of it.
I don't want a crumb left on that plate, girl.
Auntie Ethel, please. One more bite and this pie is gonna come back up to say hello.
Don't make me get the wooden spoon. You're eating for two, so get to it. Oh, if it isn't my hero. You took ages. Come in, come in. Feel free to relax yourself and have a cuppa, hmm? Gods, grant me patience. Eat up, Mayrina. I won't say it again. Keep that hole under your nose shut, or things will get messy.
You know what that sounds like to me? Leverage.
What is it? What's going on? What?
No! Dead! Everyone's dead!
Such dramatics. Enough! Away with you! Blessed silence at last. Some time in the cage should do her good. And you! You'll regret sticking your nose in my business.
should get started.
I'm ready. On the move. Position.
Let's light them up.
Let's end this. Got to press on.
Unleash me.
Might as well.
Consider me intrigued.
You are as thick as they come, sweetness. This is my personal playhouse, and you don't have an invite. Get out! Has that Riddler eaten your brain already? Leave, or you'll end up in tonight's stew. You'll go nicely with Mayrina. She's already marinating.
Please!
What is this place?
Away! Away! No, no! Don't look! Mustn't look, mustn't see! I see it. What's to come? Me. Dead. Dead! Flesh rotten, bone shining! No. No! Can't stop! Can't! Gods, don't hurt me! Oh, please, 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 please! No! No! Monster! The mind dripping, flesh peeling, mind flayer! No! No! Mind flayer! Get away! Get away!
No intention of letting that happen.
Look.
You feel crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through. Not again. Images flash. A man cowering, a bag open at his feet. Gold coins spilling onto the floor. His cries for mercy are cut short as the hag slices into him, dismembering him painstakingly, limb by limb. She cackles, the man's remaining flesh twisted and contorted, becoming the twisted surface of the door before you. Flee, you feel it cry. A scene appears in your mind. Two paladins and a cleric marching through the door, shrouded in the glow of the divine. Weapons brandished, they charge into the hag's lair. Screams of terror pierce the air.
You let them in? Naughty. That's a decade for each. You're mine for 30 more years, Petal.
You see an image of blue skies and sunshine as the door shudders a warning. Run. Its form flickers, and you realize that the door is transparent. You see the hag, eyes bright with glee, as she sets fire to the door. With a jerk, you're pulled from the vision. The presence within shrinks, begging you not to run through it.
Away! Away!
What path lies before me?
Don't look. Don't! Stop. Please. Please! Away! Away! Don't look. Don't! Stop. Please. Please! Away! Away! Don't look. Don't! Stop! Please! Please! Away! Away! Don't look! Don't! Stop! Please! Please! Away! Away! Don't look! Don't! Stop! Please! Please! Away! Away!
Tried to steal from Auntie. Now the good little pet guards my home.
Away!
You feel crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through. Not again. Images flash. His cries for mercy. She cackles. The coming. Flee. You feel it cry. A scene appears in weapons. Screams of.
You let them in? Naughty. That's...
The door stays silent. Firmly closed as the presence huddles within.
Away! Away!
I'll give it a shot.
My gentle Lauren.
Don't!
He wished to know what was to come.
Don't!
Please! Please!
Not bad. I've had better days. And worse ones.
Wait!
Let's have a look at myself. I wonder if the gods are watching me.
Don't look. Don't! Stop! Please!
My dearest Efren, he begged me to halt the deadly disease that ravaged him.
Away! Away! Don't look.
No thanks.
Feel the barest hint of life from within the door. You see the hag, eyes bright with glee, as she sets fire to the door. With a jerk, you're pulled from the vision. The presence within shrinks, begging you not to run through it.
Hurt them.
to last much longer.
Stop! Please!
Time to rest.
Away! Away!
Need to find a way forward.
Don't look. Don't!
Yes, Auntie. I'll break them.
May the gods take you first.
Get this mask off me!
Take you.
Fading fast. I need healing.
I'll fill that one later.
Let's get going. Let's have a look.
Let's get on with it.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
Patched up. Pushing on.
Another step forward. Blood. No, never mind.
Trap. Be cautious.